I guess my tape measure disappeared.
Let me just take a look off my bag if you want to.
Can we do assemble this clip board?
Yeah, go ahead and put the whole piece together. piece of the transition done. Working on the filter. Alright, we got our second piece. Two more pieces to do. Transition's done. Filter's done. I'm gonna go ahead and get the drain done while you're straightening all those out.
All right. Is that all the F-slots you have?
Finished up the drain. About to find out how good Ben really is with transitions. So Zach taught you anything? All this will fit together just like I wanted.
Funny. So you're funny.
I don't know. And it works like that, does it?
It never does for me.
Cut it a little bit too long. Take a little bit off.
Don't let that blow up in your face.
Blow up in my face. Was it popped off and hit you before?
Yeah. In plumbing. You cut it too short, it can explode. What else was there? Something else. There's something else you could do and it would just explode. And it normally wasn't me, it was the people around me I had to worry about.
Yeah.
They wouldn't pay attention.
Of course, I already took all the glue back. Still got some tidying up to do out here too. Zip tie this. I did this as soon as we got here. So I hope it'll be dry. By the time we're ready to leave, I can cut it flush with the wall, cement patch it. And that's the hole for the old one. Same thing with it. Everything's pretty much coming together. I have to do the gas pipe. And Ben's finishing that transition. That's pretty much it. Then just your regular startup stuff, static pressure, temperature, refrigerant pressures. Get it dialed in right. It's about all that's left to do. Put a thermostat on, gotta do that too. So everything's coming together pretty good. It's actually moving a little bit faster than I thought it would, to be honest. Only 10:30. Doing the gas pipe's my least favorite part. Not looking forward to that. See how that goes. All right. Thank you. Come on. Jesus. Tight fit. Okay, how do I want to do this? Backfire in my face, I know it is. Sweet. Now the part I've been dreading this whole time.
I really thought I'd hate to transition from living gas lines.
I hate them both equally. But if I had to pick one that I hate, it'd definitely be gas lines. If there's one that I could get out of every single time I did a job, this would be it. Man, I'm tightening that. Maybe something didn't feel right. Yeah, that's better. How long of a piece I need. Gotta finish this gas line and put the thermostat on. We can start it up and do all our testing. We're getting close. I just hate doing gas pipe. So much. If I got 245s, I'll be in there. Programming the board, do the thermostat, turn it on. Got the gas line done. It's going. Check around everything. Make sure I don't have any leaks. Looks good. Starting it up, turn, supply, static probes. Went blank for a second. Got these on, and I'm about to cover this up because the sun's hitting right on it. Startup sheet out. I made up a startup sheet that I have them do every time they install a new system. That way if something happens, I can go back and look at it and see if there's anything out of the ordinary at startup that they didn't see. Yeah, they're pretty quiet.
That's good.
Let's see here. TXV. 413. Yeah, I'm done with it. Put that on the truck too, please. Supply static pressure 0.33. Turn 0.61. 9.5.
cover and then body.
Maximum static pressure, 0.7 inches of water column. Have a model and serial number. Doesn't look like it. Scott Depot, just right off the exit.
Oh, okay.
Hey, can you grab my scales and a bottle of 410A?
Yeah.
I'm going to add a little bit. It can do different speeds.
Okay. So like for the furnace, it's going to be slower?
It'll be a little bit slower, not a whole lot.
Okay.
to put caps on the pipe?
No, they don't need caps. You don't want caps on. Especially that one. That one has to stay open.
It does stay open. Now, do I put a tablet in that in the front area too? Does it matter?
I mean, you could, I guess. It wouldn't hurt anything.
If it doesn't help any.
If the tablets work, yeah.
They just keep the fungus out of it.
It's the same thing. They do the same thing the vinegar will do. So if you pour the a little bit of vinegar down this once a month, it's going to go into the pump.
Okay. It won't hurt it.
No. Okay. I just know some of those tablets don't work very well. I've tried a couple of different kinds.
Oh, really?
And some of them don't dissolve all the way like they're supposed to, and they leave this weird residue behind. It just kind of sets in the pan.
Does it corrode?
I don't know if it would corrode it. It's just some kind of weird residue it leaves behind for some reason. What was the temperature in your house, do you know?
Seems like it was 76.
Okay.
Wasn't that what the temperature was upstairs? 76 or so, when you put that thermostat in?
Yeah, I think it was around that.
You can go and put this door back on if you want. The screws are right there. I'm done inside there. I wasn't holding my tongue, right? It's not real low, it just needs a little bit.
much left in this tank.
Will you see if the both those holes where I spray foamed them, see if they're if it's ready to be cut off?
Okay.
If it's set or not. If it's ready to be cut off, then we can cut off and patch, cement patch it. Mine doesn't look like Zach's. Mine's in a white tub. It's under the, if you go in on the right side, the ones with the slide-out drawers, it's right under that where, like, my recovery tank or machine and stuff is. Much more than that in it. Was a line set length. Let's do this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. About 20 feet. So if we go to the HVA school app. Go to tools. Just no charge. What does it say? 6 feet. It's only 3 ounces. Hello? Hello?
I think I'm just gonna leave it where it's at. X13 motor. Third quarter, 3/8, 20 foot. Outdoor temp, 85.
Would it be the like a separate bucket or something? It's all.
Oh, yeah. If you get in the back of my truck on the left side, there's a bunch of little small buckets. I think there's a little coffee one that I usually use. All
right.
And then under that's a bunch of bottles of water. Just don't use the water that's blue.
Okay. And do you have like a?
Yeah, it should be on that same shelf with the buckets somewhere. Now my subcooler is coming up. Stickers and make it look so ugly. Put a little bit more in it. Let it run for a little bit. Calls for 8 on the subcooling. Plus or minus 3. I like to be on the lower end. On the minus 30s out of it. Everything turned out pretty good though. Probably gonna sweat for a little bit. It's definitely nicer than what was there. For sure. It's draining good. Put some of the Viper pan and drain treatment in it before I leave. All right, I'm gonna give another little shot and call it good. Almost at 5 subcooling. Love this stuff. It works great so far. Tested at my house to see how it did. Haven't had any problems. Everything stays pretty clean. 140 low side pressure. Line temp is 61. Superheat 12. GXV is working. High side 323. Line temp is 94. Subcooling is 6.87. We'll say 7. All right. Temperature. Supply dry bulb temp 59. Wet bulb 56. Return 74. Wet bulb 66. Temperature split 14. It's not the best. But I'm also got one in the return and one just on a register that's not opened all the way, so probably a little bit off. That's it. We're done. Everything turned out pretty decent. Customer's happy. It's running good. You have to move. I was just looking. Oh. All right, well, we're gonna finish getting cleaned up and get out of here. Thanks for watching.